Hello everyone. Welcome to Food Tech Network. If you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel yet, then subscribe it now. And don't forget to click on the bell icon. For regular updates, visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in and join our groups. We share jobs, webinars, quizzes, trainings, news on daily basis. We never charge any consultancy fee for jobs. So our today's lecture will be based on chocolate processing and cacao beans processing. So chocolate is a product processed from cacao. Cacao is rich in flavonoids and antioxidant compounds. It grows best in tropical rainforest. Okay, so chocolate processing consists of a multiple processes, which is starting from cacao beans. Okay, cacao beans are farmed and then their pods are being plugged. And then they are stored and fermented, dried, clean, roast. Okay, roasting is one of the major processes. It develops the chocolate flavor in cacao beans. Before that, they are unripe and they have moisture. And after roasting, they are dried and they have a flavor developed of chocolate. Okay, before that, there is no flavor of chocolate in cacao beans. Roasting has a major role in chocolate flavor. Then they are winnowed, alkalized, blend, there is myelin, and then cocoa liquor and cocoa mass are being formed and are being pressed. Okay, then conching, and then we get chocolate. So this whole chapter is based on how we get chocolate from cacao beans. Okay. So cacao has been cultivated by many cultures for at least 3 million in Mesoamerica. Okay, so there are many processes involved, and cacao is mainly a fruit of cacao tree. Its scientific name is Theobroma cacao. Okay, so from the processed cacao beans comes the fluid placed paste or liquor, okay, which is known as cacao powder or cacao liquid. Okay, so from that we make chocolate. Chocolate is used in many of the confectionery industries, in cookies or syrups, toppings, chocolate milk. Okay, next, here is the cacao tree and here are the cacao pods. Okay, in the left hand side it is cacao tree, and in right hand side it is cacao pod. So process of making chocolate starts from the selection of fruits. Okay, so the fruits are being selected and they are checked of their ripeness. Like cacao picking is a difficult task. Underripe cacao won't have developed all its flavor and aromas. Okay, pods don't ripen at some time, even those on the same time. Okay, so then they are picked. After checking their ripeness, they are being picked. Once a producer knows their crop is ready to harvest, they hand pick the pods. Okay, it is not being picked by machines and all. It is being hand picked. Okay, then there is a pods and beans separation. Okay, so the picker picks the pods and put it in a basket. Okay, so next comes the quality control. They will inspect it and for purpose, okay, which is fine cacao, and they check the amount of pulp and the ripeness in the cacao. If it overripe, they will be fermented and sold. If it but kept separated from the high quality cacao, there is a sorting of cacao. Okay, so next comes the cacao processing. Now that the cacao has been harvested and sorted, it's ready for the next stage, that is fermentation. Okay, so let us start fermentation. Fermentation is when sugar and starch are broken down into acids or alcohol. Okay, so cacao is fermented in wooden boxes at the same day the harvesting happens. Okay, there are two boxes. One is of 180 kg of wet cacao filling with 0.5 by 0.6 meter box. Okay, and the big box is double that size. Okay, so fermentation begins when the sugar starts get concentrated and temperature rises up to 58 degrees Celsius. Okay, so while fermentation is happening, the pulp will drip off the beans. The fermentation boxes have holes that the pulp can drift off easily. Okay, they drip off the beans. So next is drying. So after the lengthy fermentation process, the beans are ready to be dried. This is another crucial step in the enhancement of cacao flavor. Okay, so cacao is dried in wooden boxes, beds, pellets. Okay, and then the drying stage should bring humidity levels down to 60% to 70%. Okay, then there is aging. Okay, so this step can last from 30 days up to 1 year. Okay, so the beans are being stored in sacks in a storage houses. However, we should be careful with humidity levels. Okay, so storing the cacao beans are now finally ready to be sell, and it is ready for the buyer to collect it. Now comes the roasting. Okay, so these were all the cacao processing, and now we are starting towards chocolate processing. Okay, so roasting is the correct way to roast level is the process which provides nibs in an efficient and cost effective manner with a system chosen flavor system. Okay, so cacao beans are roasted to develop further the original cacao flavor that exists in the form of precursor generated during the process of fermentation and drying of the beans. Okay, so fermentation, drying and roasting, these thrice involves in the for the chocolate flavor. Okay, so during roasting of the dried fermented beans, several physical and chemical changes take place, which includes the following. Okay, so first is loosening of the shells. Second is moisture loss from the beans, about 2% of final content. Okay, third is the nibs, the cotyledons. Okay, so become more friable and generally darken in color. Okay, and fourth is additional reduction in the number of microorganisms. Fifth is degradation of amino acids take place and proteins are partially denatured. Okay, so the natural reducing sugar are almost destroyed during the degradation of amino acids. Okay, so this is all about roasting. Next is shell removal. Okay, so the shell removal process is also known as winnowing. Okay, so winnowing describes the separation of shell, that is hull, and the meat of the bean, that is nib. The light broken shell are removed by a stream of air. Okay, so winnowing. Okay, so before press, let me conclude all the that we have. Okay, we have. Learn is before processing cacao are passed through a process of cleaning, breaking and winnowing to obtain nib of consistent quality. Okay, so these processes also ensures that the nibs are clean, free from dirt, infestation, okay, well broken and properly deshelled. Okay, so the kernels, nibs are also known as kernels. Okay, obtained after the process must be uniform in size and achieve constant quality. Okay, so the process involves first sieving the beans and removing all extraneous material and such as stones, strings. Okay, we have learnt it earlier, I have told you. Okay, so there are many winnowers or giant winnowing machines. Okay, so breaking and winnowing steps are vital in separation, and the essential components of the beans, the nibs and the shells, and the shells are the then discarded and sold for use for agriculture. Okay, and next is sterilization is also there. Sterilization is a technique of exposing the cacao beans or nibs to sufficiently higher temperature for a sufficiently long time to destroy all microorganisms in the beans, depending on the factory and equipment's use. Okay, so the treatment can be done in a batch of continuous process by wetting or heating with system. All microorganisms that might have contaminated the nibs will be died. Okay, next is nib grinding. Okay, so nib grinding involves milling of cacao nibs to form cacao liquor. So the purpose is to produce as a low viscosity as possible to obtain smooth cacao powder and chocolate taste during subsequent use of the liquid. The nib has a cellular structure containing about 55% cacao butter in solid from logged within the cells. Okay, so grinding nib cells releases the cacao butter into liquid with particle size up to 30 μm. And yeah, for production of cacao powder, fine grinding is very important. Okay. So the viscosity of liquor is related to the degree of roasting preceding the grinding to moisture content of the nib. Many machines are used for reducing the nibs into liquor, and these include stone miles, disc miles, pin or hammers also. Okay. So the grinding is done in multi-stage process, and the heat treatment generated during the grinding process causes the cacao butter in the nib to melt. Okay. So forming the cacao liquor. So the refined cacao liquor is heated in storage tanks at a temperature of about 90 to 100 degrees Celsius for aging and microbial destruction, after which the liquor is being packed for sale. Okay. So typically approximately 78% to 90% of cacao butter is collected by pressing, and then residual lipids may be removed by supercritical fluid extraction. Okay. So the next step is alkalization. Okay, so alkalization is a so the technique of alkalization was first introduced by a Dutchman known as Van Houten, okay, in 1928. Okay, so this consists of treating the cacao nibs with an alkali solution such as potassium or sodium carbonate. The alkali is used to raise the pH of the beans or nibs from 5.2 to 5.6, okay, to near neutrality at 6.8 to 7.5. It changes the pH of the nibs, okay, depending on the alkali used. Okay, the purpose are primarily to modify the color and flavor of the cacao powder or cacao liquor, or and also improve the dispersibility or suspension of cacao solids in water. Okay, so during this process, the alkali solution is sprayed into the drum after it has been charged with the nibs. Okay, so which is then slowly dried at a temperature below 100 degrees Celsius. Next is liquor pressing. Okay, so cacao butter constitutes about half the weight of cacao nib. This fat is partially removed from the cacao liquor by means of hydraulic pressing, applying pressure as high as 520 kilogram centimeter per centimeter square. Okay, so and the larger presses take a charge up to 113.4 kg per pressing cycle. Okay, so depending on the pressing time and the setting of the press, and resulting cake may have fat content between approximately 10 to 24%. The two kind of cacao cakes has been obtained by the process of liquor processing. Okay, so yeah, like first is the high fat cake containing between 20 to 22% residual fat in the pressed cake, and second is low fat cake containing 10 to 12% residual fat in the pressed cake. Okay, so cacao butter is extracted, is discharged into receptacles. Okay, so then from which it is pumped into an intermediate tank for processing. Okay, so cacao butter is being separated from, next topic is cacao butter is separated from cacao. Sorry, cacao is separated from cacao butter. Okay. So yeah, so the powder grinded lines usually comprises hammers, disc, pins. Okay. So the powder is then cooled after pulverization so that the fat of cacao powder crystallizes into stable form. Okay. So how cacao butter is being obtained is like also the methods I have told you. Like up to this point, the manufacturing of cacao and chocolate is identical. Okay, so the byproduct of cacao and cacao butter is essential component of chocolate. Okay, so about 25% of weight of most chocolate bars is the byproduct of cacao and cacao butter. Okay, so to make cacao powder, chocolate liquor is pumped into hydraulic presses. Wait, okay, I have told you these. Okay. Now cacao butter. So the other product obtained from pressing cacao liquor is cacao butter. So it is one of the most expensive ingredients used in chocolate recipe, and it is like dark brown. For example, shipments that are dark brown rather than golden in color warrant further tasting. It indicate improper handling during processing. It should not be dark brown. Next is other ingredients are added in chocolate liquor. Like every chocolate requires their specific ingredients. Like milk chocolate requires sugar, milk or milk powder, cacao liquor, cacao butter, lecithin and vanilla. White chocolate requires different ingredients and plain dark chocolate requires different. Okay, so let us check the processes involved in chocolate manufacturing. Okay, so chocolate manufacturing processes generally shares common features such as, you know, first is batching. Okay, so it is the combining of cacao liquor, sugar, sweeteners, milk powders, cacao butter and non-volatile flavoring materials as specified by recipe or formula. Okay, so mixing of ingredients during chocolate manufacture is fundamental operation employed using time temperature combination in continuous or batch mixtures to obtain constant formulation consistency. Okay, so in batch mixing, chocolate containing cacao liquor, sugar, as I have told you, so there is continuous mixing is usually used by large chocolate manufacturers such as Nestle, Cadbury, using well-known automated kneaders producing somewhat tough and texture plastic consistency. Okay, so next is the particle reduction. So the particle reduction of chocolate is the required to produce the smooth and smooth product to that most consumers expect. Okay, so it is important for smooth texture that is desirable in modern chocolate confectionaries. Mixtures of sugar and cacao liquor at an overall fat content of about 8 to 24% are refined to particle size that are less than 30 μm, normally using a combination of 2 and 5 roll refiners. Okay, next is standardization. Okay, so it is the final process in which the step where the viscosity of the chocolate is being adjusted with the addition of fats. Usually cacao butter and emulsifiers, volatile flavor materials may also add it to this point. Okay, so uncontrolled crystallization of cacao butter typically results in crystals of varying size. Okay, so some or all lards typically result in crystal of varying size. Okay, so this causes the surface of chocolate to be mottled, okay, or milled. Okay, so the uniform sheen and crisp bite of properly processed chocolate are result of consistently small cacao butter crystals produced by the tempering process. Okay, so tempering is a process by which a uniform and sheen crisp bite of properly processed chocolates, okay, are resulting. Okay, so next is, yeah, you can see the images of cacao beans, cacao liquor, cacao butter, cacao powder, cacao bar or chocolates. It is the conclusion of our whole lecture that cacao pods are being is being plucked off, then it is fermented, dried, roasted, winnowed, grinded, sterilized, mild, and then conching. Okay, so you remember what is conching? So it is a complex process that has been and continues to be studied in great detail in an effect to fully understand changes that occur in the chocolate during the processing. Okay. Next is, here also comes the summary in one page or two page. Okay, so the cacao beans are cleaned to remove all extraneous material and to bring out the chocolate flavor and color. They are being roasted, then they are winnowed. A winnowing machine is used to remove the shells from the beans to leave the leave just the cacao nibs. Then cacao nibs undergo alkalization, usually by with potassium chromate. Okay, so then those nibs are then mild to create cacao liquor, and then there is liquor pressing which results in No, they are blended together and the cacao liquor is pressed to extract the cacao butter, leaving a solid mass called cacao press cake. So, cacao press cake is low fat cake and high fat cake, I have told you, okay. So, the processing now takes place in two directions. So, then cacao liquor is used to produce chocolate through the addition of cacao butter. Other ingredients such as sugar, milk, emulsifying agents and cacao butter equivalents are also added. Then mixture undergoes refining process. Refining improves the texture of chocolate. Then next it undergoes the batching, the particle reduction, quenching and standardization process. And then it is packed to for distribution to retail outlets. That's all for today. Do visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in for more info.